there is a gap between the arm, upper arm, and then thigh bridge area, breathe, and gap. So that would be a bit more talking about me or me right there. So my thing was, at the time while we are looking at the find that space, no need to move your elbow far, just feel that space, that how much you are creating, that area, and then try to make your sternum space wider. Relax your eyelids, eyebrows, face region. Use proper your skin bones, your thighs, your calf, bring down your external leverage. Find your tailbone and up of the head, neck, back, in line, belly front, just feel breath in and out, try to make your concept again, back to yourself, back to your mat. Take your own body and breathe. After making comfort yourself, now join the palm, Namaskar Mudra. So the right represents your right energy. As you know, the sun energy, the physical energy, all that is what we need mostly. The left sign of your moon energy, emotions, mental, as we need in the night time for proper sleep and proper relaxation. So combination of right palm and left palm. It's called Namaste and same time it's called salute to from our own individual self to others, respect to others, from inside to out. Take a deep breath in. From here, inhale, arms up, concentration forward, exhale, palm on the floor. So if I am going to show you the body, it's like this, palm on the floor. So while our palm on the floor, now bend, elbow. So see the action of my back is bent while I'm stretching my arms or I'm bending my elbow on the floor. Action of the back is almost bent. If not, there any lounge and any arm on the back. Inhale, stretch the arms. Exhale, bend down. So keep moving your navel, your chest forward. Inhale, stretch the arm, spread the finger. Exhale, bend down. Inhale, stretch the arm forward. Exhale. Inhale, arms up, so from here. Exhale, arm to the side. Now right arm on the floor here, just the line of your right hip, and then left arm over the head. So while our left arm over the head, now we are trying to move our right arm more and more far from our right hip, more and more far from the right hip, this way. It's going to far, far, far. And same time, the left arm over the head. But don't allow your left hip to stick it up. Let the both hips proper on the floor. Stretch your side waist well. Inhale, arm to the side waist. Exhale, left arm. Again, move the left arm far, more far in the line of your left hip and far from the hip. And then stretch your right arm over the head. Keep working to your bottom side waist area, your left side waist area here. And try to, if your neck is okay there, you can use your neck and then head up, look to the ceiling. Inhale, arm to the side waist here. And now, arms moving behind your back, heel of your finger, and press the palm there. Lift the chest, stand up, and a gentle chin up. So while you are chin up, then again, try to move your shoulder, roll back. And exhale, put your the navel forward and try to move your head down. Either you can use some blocks, rest your head on the floor, and then after while you drop your head on the mat or on the floor, now you can try to stretch your arms forward. Here, if you breathe in and out. Inhale, lift the chest, and up. Very gentle way. So always remember which way we are going, how much we are going to force that, like this here, with exhale. Same way we have to come back, not like force. So in asana, always remember which force, which energy we are going to forward, same energy we have to give back. Not like lose your energy while you are coming back. So we try that. Okay, now from here, now we are in the thunderbolt pose, stick together, knees apart. So that's one pushing arm, thighs rolling inward, knees apart, little bit, like you can use the forefinger or five finger part here between the knees. Inhale, arms up here, arms facing forward, exhale, palm on. Stretch your palms and same way like before how we did. Inhale and then exhale, bend the elbow. So while our elbow on the floor, now we can try our elbow just touching to the knee, front of the knee, and press the forearm and palm on the floor. Inhale, with keep pushing your hips now towards the heel, then stretch your arm, lengthen your back, and exhale, bend the elbow. So try to understand your back here, how your back is behaving. Shoulder moving, neck longer. Inhale, stretch the arm, stretch the finger. And exhale, bend the elbow. Elbow almost touching to the knee. And maintain your elbow and shoulder in standby. Lift the chest. Inhale, stretch the arm. Exhale, elbow on the floor. Now inhale to the tabletop here. So while we are in tabletop here, in this way, now exhale, so stretch here, and then stretch your back, lift the hips up, breathe in and out. So stretch your back, neck longer, or look towards your chin or bottom, and the reason, breathe in and out. Stretch your arm, either if you can lift the hips, lift the back up, or you can hit on the floor, breathe in. Inhale, knees on the floor here, tabletop. And while we are exhaling, now elbow on the floor, forearm on the floor here, maintain the elbow and shoulder in the same line, and exhale, lift the hip, lift the heel up. So slightly stretch your leg, lift the hip. So move your sacrum more and more up towards the ceiling. Inhale, knees on the floor. the tabletop, press the arm and foot in the line, knees and knees in the line. Exhale, elbow, forearm on the floor, and then lift your hip up. Inhale, knees on the floor, to the tabletop, press the arm, stretch the arm, knees and knees in the line, palm and foot in the line. Exhale, lift the hip to the downward dog. To the downward dog. Yes. Inhale, again, bend the elbow, bend the knee on the floor. Yes. Get the finger, elbow and foot in the line. And exhale, again, lift the hip. Now, elbow on the floor, elbow on the floor, lift the hip. Elbow on the floor, and it's just, yes, like dog. Stretch the leg, lift the heel up. Yes, put the thighs back. Exhale, come to the table top. Yes, breathe. Now, in the downward dog now, while you are lifting your body, the downward dog. Now, in the downward dog, inhale, now you are gentle, right leg forward here. Either you can use some block under your arm or without block, if you allow your fingertips, the body supporting to that much, you can fingertips on the floor here. And now, stretch the back leg here with the back hip. Now, we are trying to stretch the front leg. See the front leg? Now, move the toes back. So, this way, and maintain the gap of between your both legs is 10. So it means your middle part of the body, 10 distance with both. Fingertips on the floor or block. Put the back hip back with the chest to the front. Stretch your both legs. The front toes pointing back. The front inner arch forward. Now from here, try to move arms forward. Stretch the arms forward. Deep. Try to more and more forward your body. Either you can stay here, but try to move forward your body. So this way, while you are moving your arms forward, then try to your neighbors, your belly on the right thigh. So move your belly towards the right thigh, support it on the right thigh. Stretch your both legs, lift the chest, to the front. Exhale, gentle, bend the front leg. Again, come back, arm back. And then right leg back to the downward dog. Press the heels here, lift the tailbone, shoulder blade far, upper arm externally rotate, neck longer. Yes. Inhale, look back. Now we are going through the other leg, left leg forward. Same way, first of all, you have to walk with your back leg, right leg, lift the back heel, and then now. Try to fingertips on the floor, now try to stretch your front leg. Again, same way, like front toes pointing back, the left in the arch, the front in the arch, forward. Fingertips and foot in the line, put the left hip back, lift the chest, try to raise your chest. Look front, move the shoulder back, put the blade pulling back. Now we are going to try, stretch the arms, move forward. Your breath with your in and out. Again, your belly on your left thigh. So move your belly to your left thigh. Lift the chest. And exhale, bend the left knee, arm back, and left leg back to the downward dog. Stretch your back. So I'm externally rotate here. Press the wishbone. Stretch the finger, breathe in and out. Now inhale, look front with both legs. See how we are going to forward. Now lift the toes, heels up, and we are walking forward. With the both knees, lift the both heels up, walk forward. Walk forward. Walk forward. Breathe here. Now see, our feet apart here. Heels on the floor now, feet apart here. After feet apart here, now we are moving our arms far from each other. eyes moving back up from your belly and belly moving back towards the heart. Now here, inhale, look front. Now see, big toes together, big toes together. Now big toes together. Now wrap your right leg on the left. Wrap your right leg on the left. So almost try that your pinky toes, your big toes touching to each other. Now again, try to spread your arm. Leave the chest open. So try to turn the right leg, as you know, that right leg is front and left is back. So try to push the back leg, left leg, through the right. So right is pushing to the left. Go the hip forward. And now, with maintain this, we are moving our both arms towards the right side. So move your both arms towards the right side. This way. Move towards the right side. Move towards the right side. So belly almost twisted towards the right side. Keep pressing your hips, stretch your legs, pulling the hips forward, lengthen your back. Then inhale, come to the neutral, and exhale to the left side. Pull the hips again. Keep active your both legs, both shins, both thighs. Move more and more, maintain your balance, relaxing your legs, lengthen your back to the left. Now inhale to the neutral and then change the left. Now this time right to back and left, right on the right. So pinky toes again, same way, like last. But we started from here again, arms to the sideways, and then we started from the left side. So first, we are going to the left side this time. So first move your both arms to the left side. Keep lengthening your back, keep putting this time the left leg is pushed towards the right. Come to the neutral and exhale to the right side. Stretch your leg. Neck longer, comfortable, let the toes and heels on the floor. Inhale to the neutral and then release. So release here, get your side hips and then come up to the tendon. Now come to the front of neck for Surya Namaskar, come to salutation. Warm up yourself, dry the palm. Namaskar Mudra, your breath, relax your shoulders, pick your together, shift the heart, eyes rolling in, knees facing forward, tailbone putting down, and lift it up. Belly soft, chest open, turn up, shoulder blade down, and roll the shoulders back. Chin parallel to the floor, relax your face. Spread your each chin and the toes. Just the big toes together. Now take a deep breath in. Inhale, open your eyes, arms up. Exhale, palm on the floor. Inhale, the right leg back, right knee on the floor. Arms up. Put the right hips forward, stretch your arms. Back bend yourself. Navel up. Exhale, palm on the floor. Spread the finger, middle finger pointing forward, left leg back to the plank pose. Navel pushing back to the lower back, so maintain and force the gaze here. And lift that chin. Inhale. Press the back kick, spread the toes, lift the chest. So pelvic resting on the floor, just up, shoulder back. Exhale. Big toes together. Lift the hip up. Chin from the floor. Push the sacrum up to the ceiling. Stretch your back. Inhale. Looking front, keeping your palm, then right leg forward. lengthen the right knee and right leg along the line. Keep left knee on the floor. Throw the left high kick. Put the left hip forward, left arm up, and slightly back bend yourself. Keep putting your chest up, then walk up. Exhale, palm on the floor. Look front, and then left leg forward. Here, either we can stay here in Ardha Uttanasana, look front, or we can grab your ankle, bending elbow, and go further. Inhale, arms up. Lift your chest slightly back on yourself, arms moving back, hips forward. And exhale, palm on the floor. Inhale, left leg back, left knee on the floor. Right knee just over your right ankle, then raise your arms up. Put the left hand forward, right side roll out, the left side roll in. Exhale, palm on the floor. Spread the fingers, press the palm, right leg back. Go together, double moving back. Now knee chest in. Ashtanga Namaskar, 18 on the floor. Inhale, cobra pose. Exhale, lift the hips up and back. Inhale, left leg crunch. Right knee on the floor, hold the right high kick, arms up, and back bend yourself. Exhale, palm on the floor, look front, and then right leg forward. And then you can go further, or you can stay there, and then inhale, arms up, slightly back bend yourself. Exhale, palm on the floor again. Inhale, the right leg back, right knee on the floor, arms up. Put the right hip forward. Exhale, palm on the floor, then left leg back. Knee chest in on the floor. Inhale, cobra pose. Exhale, mountain pose. Inhale, look front, between the palms. Right leg forward, left knee on the floor, arms up. Exhale, palm on the floor, left leg front. Inhale, arms up, back bend yourself. Exhale, palm on the floor. Inhale, left leg back, left knee on the floor, arms up. Exhale, floor, then right leg back. Now this time we are going to right side, left arm middle of the mat, stretch your both legs, lift the hip, right arm up, and then right arm over the head, lift your hip up. Look up to the ceiling, or either you can look down. Exhale, right arm on the floor. Again, lift the hips up, left arm up, and over the head. Exhale, left arm on the floor. Inhale for the pose and exhale mountain pose. Inhale left leg crunch, right knee on the floor, arms up. Exhale palm on the floor, right leg forward. Inhale arms up and exhale turn the palm. Now, Samasthiti, palms facing forward. Close your eyes. Breathe in and out. Stay parallel to the floor. Close your eyes. Longer and deeper. Now open your eyes. So as we know that today's practice is called like inverted posture. So inverted means how we are upside down, how the navel of the head is going down, the upper body, the pelvic and navel is going up. So here increase the flow of the blood then the brain is also purified in the inversion. Inversion posture, so as my understanding about the inversion posture is not like yesterday practice arm balance. It's like we need balance and we need same time stability, we need same time hold and the power to hold a little bit longer stability in the inverted. So yesterday practice arm balance is like force, it's not that much force there, but here inverted posture we need to hold. Any kind of inverted, that's a slow pose, that's a dog pose, and even that's adjacent arm balance, we need the stability. How much we are with our weight, with our stability, and with our the stay in the posture, that would be more, give us more awareness and more insert ourselves in the yogi. So that's the inverted posture. Inverted posture means when we are going to sleep on class, that's the before class, we do the inverted posture. Because now our body prepares to be stable. Because now our mind is also going to stay. So flushing the toxin and like the nervous system also, that's more activated in this posture. Like few people then when they have like anxiety, insomnia, like some like mental also relaxation. Proper mental awareness also is inverted. As you heard, there are some people, anger, those kind of people every day half an hour, 1 hour. The more the yogi in the traditional yogi, they do the inverted posture more and more, like 15 minutes at least, one posture, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. So it means you need to gain the stability in inverted posture, not quickly go and down. You need to be the practice and gain the power. So, okay, that means I try to rejuvenate our body in inverted posture. I started through the sthanasana. Sthanasana also we call the inverted posture. So we started through the uthanasana. So uthanasana generally, there are different ways of uthana. Uthanasana generally, we do the uthanasana, feet apart, and this is the normal, half the uthanasana. If somebody needs there, the light is not proper, we can use the block if you are teaching to somebody, even if you are working on your arm self. So see, my back and how my hips are rolling forward. If my hips are tight, my hamstring is tight, so what happens? All the glutes is going to downward here. So what happens? That's going to my back is like this. So it means that's why the many teachers, that's why we are in, when we are in class, we tell the people, okay, bend your knees and look front. We force you to bend your knees and look front. But how long? How long we need to bend our knees? It means not for all our life. It means we have to work here in the calf, in the back knee, and in the hamstring. It's not that bend the knees, so that person will be all over here, bend the knees and look front, bend the knees. So that is not the limit. It means same time bend the knees for the class we are doing, but same time we have to work in this area. Otherwise, what happens? I'm always weaker here. If my hip is rolling forward, if I am rolling, I'm squeezing this all the, and pulling this all the muscles forward and rolling my hips like forward. So how my hips is going to forward, falling forward, that much my back would be more perfect. So here is about this area, how you are pulling this area forward. That's why we do the block sometimes in our arm practice, even sometimes we give in the students like how they maintain. So here I'm maintaining my arm, my leg is stable there. And I am going to try to concave the natural arch of my lower back. So uthanasana, we need how to create the natural arch of our lower back. It means natural arch of the lower back means we are in natural back there. So it means in uthanasana, see, even in uthanasana, if I am going to create the natural arch of the back. So it means I am pulling my hips forward. Then my spine is going to natural arch. In my spine is going to lengthen. Okay, see, okay, wait, it's the other idea. Other idea, if we have the block, the wall. So in the wall, even we are going to sit or standing. If we have the wall, we are just making about 90 degrees in the wall. My palm is there, my palm, my hip in same line, my leg, my heel, and my hip in the same line. I'm creating, I'm going to lengthen my back. See, my back is going to long. My hips going to active. And I'm putting my thighs, my femur, back, back, back. Then I'm creating the space in my vertebra and spine. Same, if you want to go with knees on the floor, same action, hips would be like this. Knees on the floor, hips, same length, and space. Now knees, and then space. Same way, palm and shoulder, and hips, same line. My hip and my knee is the same line. So this is the one way to create the space in your vertebra, and then try to elongation of the back. So please try this one first, and then we are going to other way.
I'd like to ask you something. So all the images of people are on the side of my screen and I can't see properly what you're doing because you're doing exactly all the other camera shows me. So how can I get rid of this? Because I couldn't see you properly what you're doing with your arms.
Okay, you want again? I saw you.
You know what I mean?
Sorry, I put you on, I put Anoop on pinned. That he should supposed to be the one who's on. Maybe you can add on the gallery on top right, there's the view. You put the speaker view.
Yeah, but show me the little screens with everyone, you know what I mean?
Yeah, this is the gallery.
On
I think,
the screen,
I think
if
you have
go on the screen on top.
Yeah.
Yes.
You have the possibility to shut them off.
But it shows view.
Yeah,
exactly.
I press gallery.
Yeah, no, not gallery. You do the speaker view. There's
an
option.
I press speaker.
Yes.
Because it's selected now.
Yeah. Is it selected now?
What's selected?
Well, change from gallery to speaker. Change around and see if anything of the view changes.
Pin
is like the speaker. You can pin this speaker, so then it will not change for you, whoever is talking.
And if you go on the top, from the middle pictures, on the top one,
yes,
there on the frame above.
Oh, yeah, I see. Thank you.
You're
thank
welcome.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Good.
Now you will see only me.
Yes, that's what I want.
That's good.
Thank you.
Okay. So you got the point how we are going to run the two ways. One is the 90 degree standing way. One is the 90 degree. Again, I'm showing you. One is the 90 degree. Your hips and your hips in same line. Your palm, your shoulder, and your hips in the same line. The 90 degree. And in the 90 degree, what we have to do exactly, we have to arm here. At the same time, we have to put our hips far on the wall. Far on the wall. Put the hips far from the wall. Put the hips apart from the wall. How much you will put your hips apart from the wall, that much you will be able to lengthen your back, elongation of the back. So, even if you are, see, come here, Julia. See, if you are even, please, for 1 minute, can you see here? See, everybody, for 1 minute, please, if you are teacher, so these are the tips maybe important for you. Beginner person, so now see how much he can allow. That much. Sadhana. So what is the next one? If you want to try, okay, quickly one try. And if you finish, then we can go carry on. Because there are a lot of posters. Please quickly, for a few minutes, so 1 minute, 2 minutes, and come back. Arm and shoulder, and hips in the line. Try to engage the lower back. Try to push your hips back far from the wall. Spread the fingers. Yes. Shoulder blades apart from each other. Breathe in and out.
Do we need to arch the back?
Arch. Like this. Paschimottanasana, sitting forward bend. Janusirasana. And this one, 90 degrees. Uttanasana, we need to arch. Okay, come back. See, the next one. If you have the steps, so everybody, if you have the steps, so I am going to show you one thing more. If you have the steps there, so see, with the step, you need bend the knees and just put the step almost near of your sacrum. See, almost near of your sacrum here. This is. And now the bottom side of the step, just under your inner arch, under the feet. See, bottom side here, arch area, middle of the feet, side, the sacrum. Okay. And now, so according your height, you have to create that. And if you are little stiff, your back is not that much open. Hamstring tight, calf tight, neck is tight. You can use the block here and then try to stretch. And you will create how much stability on your leg, how much you can lengthen your back here. Otherwise, you can use the fingertips there or palm there. But it should be active and tight. If you want more, you can again little bit bend your knees, again little side there, again the step right there, and then stretch the leg. The thighs back, hold the thighs in. So quickly try this one also. Make it one try. Yes, place on your sacrum and between the feet. So both joints almost in the same line with your extra. Okay, if you're done, then come back, please. Now see, I'm showing you the downward facing dog. So about the downward facing dog, what happens with our body? So mostly what we do in see, I'm showing you the demo. Either table doctor or dog doctor. Your knees on the floor, stay. Now, lift the hips up. Hips up. See, if you are looking here, in this body, what happening here? See, this part, the beginner. He is the beginner. So what happens? We feel the beginner. Shoulder is falling forward. The back is flat there. Because he is more focused on his heel. He wants to unnecessarily put his heel, and then all the energy from here, the sacrum, if not, he is not able to lift that energy up. But actually, what happens in downward dog, we need to create that energy from the sacrum, lift it up. What we are getting from him, what we are getting from the feet. So see, if we allow him that, please, once there are different ways. One way, we can allow to him lift the heels up. Yes. Lift the heels up. Now he creates some pattern upward. Now see, from the shoulder, now, leave the heels up here. Now see. See, neck comfort. Now see. How is it now? Back is flat than before. Is it? What's the point? It means unnecessary the energy from the heels. He lose that energy because before he was losing that energy. Now he gained that energy with lifted heels. Now he gained that sacrum up and same time he is able to back also proper heel. See how much good than before. Okay. Other second thing. With the lifted heel, with the few people, now we are without between the shoulder blade, there is one canal, there is one always one line. So we have to reduce that line between the shoulder blades. So reduce that line between the shoulder blades. Reduce that line between the shoulder blades. And slightly, no need to squeeze somebody there, but slightly you can just make a push, otherwise the people can slip there. So you can just little bit pump a light weight of your feet there, and sometimes you can slip your head, can push their shoulder, shoulder blade back. Now see, within few seconds, how he creates the balance, how he creates his back, much than before. Okay, exhale down. So these are how we are, what I'm trying to say you, what I'm trying to speak you, see, here, and always, like arms and shoulders from the tabletop if you are here, and then see, my heels are there. And then if I'm getting that back area, see, my back is here, my hip is there, and I want to put my hips down. So these are many people in my class, what they do, when they come to first time in the class, in the, they try to this way. They hanging themselves, like this swinging way. But they don't know that with swinging, they cannot achieve anything. With the stability, with the mind, they will achieve. Now see the mind is there. I need to lift my heels up and I need to brace my back. See my leg, how much active, space of my feet, how much there, and how much my breathe. My neck is proper, my back is proper. And after when I get this back, when I get this sacrum area, when I move my thighs back, now I can allow my heels on the floor. Now, this is the way. Okay, so quickly just do one thing and I will show you the other way to how to within 1 minute straight again the adjust the downward dog. So please do one time with lifted heel, with heels on the floor, with shoulder blades far, and then with reduce that line between the shoulder blades. To put your thigh and your feet more and more far from the body. The back knee of your, the skin area of the back knee, the upper area is moving upside, the down bottom area is moving down. So the skin is like back, back knee skin is like this. The upper side is going up, bottom side is going down. It's stretching like back side of the knee.
In the lower back area, I always find that I have a really big arch, and I don't know if it's because I have it's just the line of my spine, or if it's to do with flexibility. So I just find it's really here, the lower part, it kind of sticks out, even though I'm trying to kind of feel that there's
always
a little bit of a curve.
Mm. Okay, so see, actually what happens, you are putting your shoulder much first. keep there. Second area, you are not lifting that much. One thing. So you have to more focus more than arm and hip to help on lifted up. That is the one way. The other way, while you are doing the downward up, you have to put your navel back to the lower back. Put the navel towards the lower back. Then the navel keep to the support, the belly keep to the support from lower back, and that reduce that arch area. See, if you will go that way, say arch up. If there, lift the hips up. If there are here, what we have to do, the palm, the navel is pushing back towards the navel is pushing back towards the lower back. So what happens? Then the reduce. What happens in your case? You are forcing this area much, and then so here, then this area is more hunching there, and that creates lower back. So what you have to do? You have to more focus here. Push the tailbone up and the navel same time towards the lower back. Try this one quickly. Yes, navel putting back towards the lower back and then lift the tailbone up. Good. Good. Is it helpful?
Yes, I'm not sure if I need to lift the heels to achieve it or if the heels don't matter.
If that heels don't matter there. Heels is matter there when the hump is there. In arch, heels is not matter. When the hump is there, like body back is like there, then heels matter. When the arch is there, heels not matter.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Mm-hmm. My heels is for spine elongation, not for arch. Arch is overarch means spine is more flexible.
Thank you.
Welcome. Okay, the next one. Wide leg forward fold. Wide leg forward fold. See. Feet apart, and you need one step. Again, to make little more active, how we make active in wide leg forward. So you need one step in a feet area. See. So this is the posture for Apsanga. This is the posture. Anger yoga, this is posture for hot yoga, this is posture for mostly flow yoga and every kind of other yoga, every posture, everybody. So, for what happens in this posture, the inner ankle area, we have to care about the inner ankle area. So, many people they complain to me when they are doing this posture, they feel their ankle is burning, their knees have some pain. Because the reason after age of the feet. Reason outer edge of the feet. Reason the inner ankle falling down. Because outer edge has not that much awareness, not that much stability, not that much putting down. So inner ankle, while the inner ankle is falling down, then what happens? All the pressure is going to outer ankle and the knee area. So when we are this step, see how big we are. The step between if I'm swinging. Start here, between the feet, both sides, both feet, between the feet. And now, I need to make tight this one to make more active my leg. And now see, after here, I need to move forward. Forward, but how, when I am moving forward, that time, if I am showing you, from this side, so that time, not it's like the hip is also falling forward. So hip should be there in same line. Do not disturb your hip. Hip is there. Only you have to walk through the trunk and through the arm. Now see how much we are lengthening our back. Because if this part is not lengthened, so you have no chance to hide on the floor. You will be like this. Because the back is short there. Is it? Back is short there. So when you are lengthening your back, then we have the chance, the head on the floor. Otherwise, what happens? Our head is like this. So make more active your back and move forward. So use the one step in your feet and more and more forward your arm, your neck, your quarterback, and move your arm and front forward. Look front. Yes. So maintain the hips and heels in the same line. Without move your hips, no need to move hips forward. Hips is there without disturbance. Only through the front and only through the arms you have to move forward. And if you want to stay up there, if you are very close to the ground, that time you can use some block or some bolster and your head on the bolster. So that's called inverted way. That means you can hold and that means you can stay up there. So then the chance of blood flow on your brain is because that time you are holding the bolster because your head is relaxing. So hanging head is not, we said hanging head is not prasarita bhavasanasana. Hanging head is not wide leg forward. Hanging head means we are only stretching there. If we want to complete wide leg forward board, it should be our head on the something like block, poster, or the ground. Okay, now inhale, release, and then come back. And then see. Come back. Get your side in. Now see. Left feet in and right leg out. So right heel and left arch in the same line. And then exhale. Bend the right leg. Right knee. Right ankle in the line. And you have to right thigh parallel to the foot. Now arms up and exhale. And then move the arms forward. Move the arms forward. Yes, arms moving forward. Yes, maintain the right, the thigh and the ankle in the right, thigh to be parallel. Yes. And now bend the elbow and elbow, thigh to elbow on the floor. If you want to stay there, that is okay. And either if you want a little more action there, you can bend the elbow, elbow on the floor and look front. Lift the chest and put the weak leg in bending, put that knee more back. Yes, now inhale, extend the arm and then chin. Right foot in, left leg out, chin in the back. Yes, exhale, bend the other leg and again palm on the floor. Again, move forward your arm. Yeah, pull the hip. Keep putting your hips back. And then bend the elbow, forearm on the floor. Okay, then inhale. Stretch arms and then stretch the both legs and then get your side hips, come up. Give up. Breathe. Yes, inhale, arms up, exhale, palm on the floor. Inhale, plank pose. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, for sitting. Move the shoulder back. Exhale. Downward facing. And then knees on the floor. Now, we have the posture. It's called. And that posture called is chin stand. It's a chin stand. It means where you are, palm, here, like same like Ashtanga Namaskara, like same we can say. Like Chaturanga, when we have elbows, it's bending there, spinning your elbows, and then chin on the floor. So chin on the floor here, now we are stretching our legs. But very gentle. With the chin on the floor, we are going to stretch the legs. And same way, if we are doing a walk here, so see, chin on the floor, and then we are pulling the back. See, if I am going to, elbow closer, elbow front, elbow here, yeah, elbow up, palm back, elbow palm back, at the end of, I'll say, look up, and then here, see, elbow closer, now stretch the leg, and then gentle one leg up, and then exhale, the other leg up, figure, see, stretch. So you can use the wall there for your leg, either you can use the other way, other side of the wall, see, other way of the wall, see, if you have the wall, you can move the leg up to the wall, elbow there, and then kick. But we need the palm almost like Chaturanga. So keep pushing your hips up and back and lift the tailbone up there. The thighs rolling inward and squeezing the leg. Shoulder pushing back, shoulder blade going to back. Yes, move the leg back to the wall and then try one by one. Shoulder moving back, shoulder blade back. Good. Toes pointed up. Yes, very good. Elbow closer to the knee.
Anup, did you see what I did?
Yes, I see. Again, do again. I see already.
I don't know. I always wanted to check my this Oscar. I don't know if it's correct. I'm going to do it again.
Okay, see there, Sam. There are, I told you or not yet. And they are in the balancing, mostly inverted or unbalanced. We need to carry our body weight up. Even this is called chin stand, but if you have that much potential, that much practice, so even you can lift your chin there up. See, even if you are that much potential, see, even I am lifting my chin up. It means I am carrying my body weight up. It's not why I am showing you that one, why I am saying this one, because it's not like squeezing your chin on the floor. It means you are working through your elbow, you are working through your body weight lifted up. It's not you are squeezing your chin on the floor. In wonderful. I save you on a screenshot.
I think I understand. The sheet shouldn't feel heavy, right? Like, shouldn't feel very light here. We shouldn't put pressure.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is it light now?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, it's better. Before I was like holding with my mouth, I was like, thank you.
That's only support method. Okay, now, what is the next one? After the 10 stands, that is one called next post. It's a Griva Asana. Griva Asana is also one kind of, we can say, bridge posture. Now, see. In Asana way, the people do this one. It's also one inverted posture. Head post, top of the head on the floor. Lift, top of the head on the floor. Yes, top of the head on the floor. So, top of the head on the floor, lift the heels up. Use the crown of the head on the floor, lift the heels up. So, again, I'm saying you no need to push, just as it supports your crown of the head on the floor. Which is up, again, forward. Relax, relax. Lift more forward. Forward. Now, say. Stay down of the head and lift this area up. Up join the palms, namaskar mudra. From front side. Elbow, down elbow ko pakad, elbow join ko pakad. This way, see. So this way, so crown of the head and leg little more back and try to lift the heels also. Up, lift the heels, knees closer. So this is called Griva Asana. But before that, we need to do bridge pose. So bridge pose is the preparation of the posture. So first do the bridge pose. Setu Bandha Asana. Okay, there is a one more thing, if you are listening there is a one more thing in bridge pose. Just go there and try to listen to me. In bridge pose, our chest is moving towards the chin. Not our chin is going towards the chest. Our chest is moving back towards the chin. Yes, if you are able that your chest is moving towards the chin, now you have to push your tailbone forward. Far from you. Knees facing forward and try to close the little bit more knee. Yes. Feel a little more knee. Yes. Little more closer. Yes. Good. Yeah. And the tailbone thighs rolling inward. Move your thighs. Both thighs roll inward. So if you are moving your thighs inward, there is no pressure on your lower. Otherwise, sometimes the pressure in back bend on our lower back area. So thighs roll inward, tailbone pushing forward, far from you. So there is no pressure on the lower back. So it means we need to engage our thighs forward. And then after this one, if you are able to bridge for there, if you are okay there, then you can use the crown of the head on the floor, and then same time, grab your elbow joint. Crown of the head, in bridge pose, crown of the head on the floor, and yeah, put the chest forward. Forward means backward. Yeah, put the chest far. Yeah, very good. Yes, Maya, a little more lift your hips up. Yes, exactly, very good. Very good. Jana. Okay. Now, after the bridge push, the second one means next one is our mostly in every traditional yoga. So, from where the yoga comes, alasana, shoulder stand. It means shoulder stand, slow hold, and head stand. Those are the mostly inverted posture from the traditional way. From the traditional way, ancient yoga. So sarvangasana, halasana, and shirsasana. These are also more important. These are the more important. So if somebody you want to try, if somebody even that is like a little bit older people, little bit senior people, so you have to teach them this posture. This posture so much work on the thyroid area, so much work on the mind way, so much work on your body way, energetic. So flow pose, shoulder stand, and head stand. So these are flow pose and shoulder stand always in one sequence. So see, the flow pose. Okay, other. So if you are teaching to somebody the flow pose, as you know how to do, but here you only need to know that how to do. So see, if somebody flow pose, forward. See, look to him. If, or more forward. See, first of all, when you are teaching to somebody, first of all, you have to check their shoulders proper on the floor or not. So that is the first main thing. If the shoulders are not on the floor, the pressure on the neck, and then people feel uncomfortable, so within 1 second, 2 seconds, 5 seconds, the person will come down. Then they say, oh, I'm hurting here, and this is not perfect posture for me, because the shoulder is not there. Because the shoulder is, as the name, posture, alasana, shoulder stand. They are connected to each other and both are depend on shoulder. So see, the leg up and back. See, if he's doing also good. But what we need actually is the posture. We need, first of all, the back. So little bit rounded is okay. But if you are so much rounded, what happens? About the front body, what about the ribs? They are collapsing to each other, belly is collapsing to each other, so that is not that much benefit. So it means we are just doing the posture, but there is no benefit of the posture. We are only, we want to posture to clicking the photos, put the photos in Instagram, Facebook, whatever. But there is no benefit from here. If you ask that person, real, that I had that experience last, maybe I teach. In teacher training also like 8,000 people today. So that's my own experience. The people, they do from many years, 15, 20 years. They always from here, they feel safe, sensation, without comfortness. So see, how the comfortness comes. If you give that person, like if you have some pillow or something like that, these are my house pillows. See, if we are using those pillows, leg up, here, up. Stretch your leg, now see, and then if you have the step, as I said, and if you have the without step, you can catch from here. Now see, watch here, carefully this area, see, already he makes a space there, see, right here, now see, I'm through my knees, I'm putting his hips here, and then lift, difficult for the hips. See, how much the space now? How much the space now? This area. While I'm lifted here. See, now this area is going to long. Intestine, ribs, lungs, heart, everything is spacious there. Thighs up. So thighs is going to up towards the ceiling. And shoulder, whatever the shoulder is rolling inward. Inward means you have to press your upper arm. Either you can. Yes, your feet are closer to his shoulder or her shoulder, and see, this is going to work. So this is the situation of the front pose. So you have to care about your spine, you have to care about this thing. Exhale down. Okay, if you don't have this, you can use the wall also. user one. Same thing, you have to use the one thing. You take it to enter and you have to go back. Like going towards the one. So same thing here, please fit on the one. We need to push the one and move back. Push the Q to the one and move back. Okay. Press the Q to the one. See how much the area now. So now she can stay there much, maybe more than 2 minutes, 3 minutes. But before, then now his feet was tired at that time. He was breathing tired way. Now he is breathing. His breath is proper way, and he is activating now his thyroid region. So try on the wall and other, try on the poster first, and then check today that how is the change there in your flow pool. Okay, relax. So please try that way, and then try to understand. Even if your shoulder not there proper when you are starting to flow pose, every time you have to remember when you are going to try flow pose, halasana, and you are just in beginning, so you have to walk through the shoulder little bit forward like that. Shoulder, it means well, shoulder on the floor, and then you have to little one walk from the shoulder. Walk forward, then you will feel your shoulder is, and upper arm is more proper. With the walking forward. So try from today, like 4 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes at least in flow. That's your manifest your flow all over life. And then interlock finger, you can stretch your arm, interlock your finger there to start thighs more and more far from the ground, put the thighs more and more up towards the ceiling, and create the space in your belly. Spine longer, shoulder blade up towards the hip, upper arm putting down, shoulder putting down, the back neck area longer. Okay. Okay, from here, now next one, after when you complete there, so next variation from here to the shoulder stand. So the shoulder stand also, like how we do, and if you are new, if you are teaching, you are beginner, and you are teaching to some beginner, the shoulder stand. In shoulder stand also, we have to more and how we are going through our palm towards the shoulder blade. So our palm more and more closer to our shoulder blade when we are placing the palm backside. So see, if you are push up, if you are trying with the stop, if you are trying to first approach here, now see, if my hips is there from here, and now my hip is closer to the one. And then after here, feet here, and now I am lifted my hip up. And then I'm trying to my hip forward and lift it up. Elbow closer, or either I can use some strap on my elbow. Shoulder more and more. So maintain the shoulder, your hip and knees in the same manner. Neck should be comfortable. If your neck is not comfortable here, you can use some blanket under your shoulder there. Yes. Sorry. So I'm not saying that all over life we need the blanket or we need the wall, but at least when we feel when we need that, how, what kind of awareness we need in the posture. then we need the prompt. And when we get that awareness, we no need to form. But till that, we need. Knees bend, go to the bend and push, lift. Yeah. More work, more forward, shoulders, more forward. Yeah. Now see, you can use the hip forward. Now see, shoulder, my hip is shoulder. Now I'm putting his hip forward. See, what is the alignment? Hip body now. Now, how his back? How it activate his belly? I'll activate his pelvis, his thigh. And even only one leg, stretch one leg, only one leg, up, stretch, toes pointing down, 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 down. Yeah. See how the alignment of the back. Palm pushing down, or you can use the elbow, palm goes mirror, black mirror. Yeah. See. So he can stable, very enjoyable, see. He can stable. I am only giving him the alignment of this area and he is using his back more and more, activating all the back and all the thighs, all the leg area. Now change. Gentle. Close down, inner archa. Thighs roll inward, so both thighs are rolling inward. See, even, see. So the beginner person also see, he is able. Relax down, come down very nicely, release.
Anu, okay. About the feet, we should keep the feet flexed, right? Or pointed?
Actually, what happens when you are toes pointed up, your front body is going to active. When you are hips up, your back body is going to active. You can try that. When we are stretching,
but then does it matter? Like it's not.
Does not matter. Does not matter. Matter for feet. Matter for that. If you want to try on your talon, so that is matter. You have to always use up. If you want to work on your talon, you feel the lower back stretches. You have to always use up. If you not, you don't have matter. Sometimes you need to stretch front body. Sometimes you need to stretch back body. Does not matter. So try please this one also with the walk. Elbow closer and shoulder line. If you need the step, the step also give you that alignment with the shoulder and elbow in the same line. And keep putting your hip far from the wall, shoulder and hip and knee in the same line. And try to push your hips more and more up. So your palm more closer towards the shoulder blade, and same time you have to more lifted your hips up. So palm closer to the shoulder blade, more and more down. Palm should be more closer. And hips more and more up. Thighs more and more low. The outer hips pushing to each other. The inner thighs far from each other. And in shoulder extend also, if you are doing shoulder extend in the class, so don't look your neighbor.
Don't look your neighbor.
Don't look to your next match people. Because that will going to hurt on your neck. Just look to your body. I see many people when they are doing shoulder stand, they are looking to their level, they are looking to next match. Just eyes pointed to your back, big toes region, and focusing there. Then your neck should be comfortable. That only I want to say there is inverted. So if any kind of posture is inverted you want, you need to stay over there. You need to hold there. You need to try that how you are gaining that stability and how you are gaining that, how much you are going to longer that. Then you can say clear that, okay, I am doing now headstand 10 minutes every day. I am doing shoulder stand 10 minutes every day. I am doing palm balance 5 minutes every day. I am doing flow pose 10 minutes every day. If you say something, I am doing shoulder stand 5 seconds. I am doing headstand 10 seconds. I am doing flow pose 2 seconds. So that's very funny. That means you are doing something in the name of yoga. And you are thinking that's all yoga, but that's not actually. Okay. Now see. Yesterday there was one friend of mine from US and he messaged to me, Anup, I did yoga today. I say, how long is that? 10 minutes. So I say, wow, that's so much good for me. So, okay, now we are going to headstand. As you know, the headstand also, there are some preparations. So these all the preparations to stable yourself. See the headstand. You have to do this one. This one. Huh? And then, here, interlock, up, crown of the head, and then left back. So, in this way, also, like how you teach and how you are gaining. Let's complete the hip. Check. First step all, move back. You have to check your where your hip, stretch the leg, let's sit up. This one. So where your hip there, that's your fingertips or your head also there. Now, just interlock the fingers here. So where you are with your finger, with your hip, same place you have to head on. Now see, leg. लगा ऊपर वॉल पे स्ट्रेच कर ना मोर डाउन 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 यस नाउ स्ट्रेच यस बोथ लेग अदर वन ओके नाउ सी इफ समबडी हियर नाउ वी हैव टू द फिट इनसाइड ऑफ द एल्बो फिट इनसाइड ऑफ द एल्बो थ्रो माय शिन आई एम पुटिंग इट शोल्डर लेग एंड देन सी हाउ मच द अवेयरनेस देयर आखिर active to the inside. So I'm pushing from my skin to his shoulder blade. And even he is beginner, he was able to do this one. And now lift the one leg up, gentle, and then other leg. Arms, gentle, stretch, back together. Both leg together, squeeze the both leg to each other. See the head. Any pressure on your elbow shoulder? Are pressure? Pressure hai? Kahan pe? Elbow? Yes, that's good. He says his elbow has pressure, not head. So that's the good news for us. Exhale, down. So, what we learn here, this is only one a simple demo, but what I want to say you, what we learn here how much we are using our shoulder blades. It means if I'm doing my posture, this one, see, if I'm doing the posture, mirror back shoulder in line, see, is it okay? See, if I'm here, see, my hand. See my hand, person, I am using my elbow. So if my, there is no pressure on my head, it means there is no pressure put your not pressure on my neck. Totally pressure on the elbow. Totally shoulder blade lifted up, hip up, tailbone up. So more focus, elbow pressing on the floor, and then push the body up. And see, this is also one point, the bottom wrist area. This bottom wrist area, you have to more open here, this area. If this area is like this, when you are doing like this, see here, and see here, here, or here. Yeah, so we have to open here, like this, not like this. And back, yeah, yeah. That's the way. So the small finger is pushing forward. Yeah. Breathe. Good job. है तुम्हारे यहाँ है है याद है कि नहीं देखिए अगर रूट का पे मैं उतना नहीं आ रखा हूँ अगर है तो नहीं आता रूट नहीं है तो रहने yes Okay, after when you finish here, then we are going to Supta Kona Asana. First you have to finish this one, gentle. And if you are like some are advanced practitioners, they already know about the headstand. So they can use the twisting way, they can use the leg wider way. Other way of the headstand, like how we are to stretch headstand, how we are going to lift, and how we are stretching the leg, how we are twisted our leg, far, how we are going to far, to stretch. So this way you can try that one. If you are able to, your head is there proper, your elbow is proper. So please you can try that one. Yes. Okay. You should finish there. Then we can come to the wall. Supta Kona Asana. So if you find the wall here, see. If you find the wall here, look. Here. Now I am moving my hips closer to the wall. First, I'm going to bend my knees and hips in same line from here. And now I am my right feet on the left knee or thigh. And then I'm pushing my right knee forward. Few breath here. So this is the quite posture. We can say the easier posture for hip opener. And then from here, we can left knee forward. After here, when we release, we can move our hip forward towards the wall. So almost towards the wall. This is the posture for menstruation for women also. And then leg wider. Okay, now see and bear that step. See, now how we are, I am making active all that. See, if I am using here, so that's not that much active my leg. So I am using my step in my right feet, because the right feet, same like that way. So now see, I'm stretching here. So my leg is, while I'm moving far from my feet, so it's going to create more active my leg. And then I'm going to push my thigh forward. Put my thigh forward towards the wall. And then stretch my arms back. Arm stretching up, push the hips forward, push the thighs forward, active the leg, toes pointing down, lower back on the floor, push the shoulder, arm stretching up. And see how much the change. Maybe you did before this one, but this is the new one. So this is the new one for your leg. This is the new way to active your leg. How much here you can use, how much you want, you can move wider. But with the active leg. And the other thing, what you have to care in this posture, you have to, the knees facing backward. It means your knees not inward, not outward. Knees facing to back. The knees facing in one line there, not the outside. So roll the thighs inward that much. When your knees is equally facing back, or you say facing forward. So it means your toes, your middle toes, and your knees in same line. So that you have to create. Middle toes and your knees. So create that. So that much roll your thighs in. Stretch your arms back, arms sitting up, and push the thigh again towards the wall. Now release the step and bend your knee like bound angle pose. Bend the knee. Yes, fit together. Yes, bend the knee, fit together. Knees wider. Open the knee. Yes, and push the thighs and knees forward. okay, then you can come back and queue for few minutes, for 2 minutes maybe, that's okay. You can close your eyes and I'm setting up just for relaxation yourself. Because the inverted posture needs the relaxation, needs the yourself proper, peaceful. The palm facing up, neck comfortable, close your eyes. So increasing flow to the brain means how you are stable and how you are working through your body, how you are using your inhale and exhale, how you are all the day connect with the other, and how you are focusing in your own work, in your own job. Even job of talking, even job of walking, even job of sleeping, job of eating, each and everything. How much time we are going to appreciate our food, our water, our air, our breath. Appreciation, the emotions of the appreciation, self to self. So that's great, the yoga. With the each and every connection with the nature, that's through the yoga, come out in your stuff. All the flushing out, the toxin, nourishing your nervous system, purifying and rejuvenate your energy, recirculated all the parts of the body. Circulation of the heart and lungs. Each and every system of the body is going to functioning well. Reduce your, if you have that stress and anxiety. And same time, as I mentioned, increase the self-confidence, the mental power, the decision power. So these, really these all the benefits through the inverted posture, through the yoga actually. So connect with the physical and mental. So there is the one external world, there is the one internal world. Physical is mostly connected with the external world, but emotional, the mental is mostly connected with the internal world. So internal and external, the in and out, the inhale and the exhale. And then gentle, release yourself and turn your body to the right side now. Right arm up and use the right upper arm as a pillow there and turn your body to the right side with bending knees. And gentle calm with closing eyes, come to the sitting. Now, close your eyes, join the palms. Take a deep breath in. Deep breath in. Thank you. Your palm to get your energy back and place on your eyes. Gently open your eyes behind your palm. Thank you. Namaste. Okay, now we have the 15 minutes for question answers. If any doubt, anything, you can ask me. Without any hesitation, without any. Do you funny? My time to water. Time to water. Okay, Yuki, you are good. You didn't take water today. Very good. Wonderful. Always in yoga, what we said, if you want to drink water, so as a sip, like tea, as a sip, not like gut, the throat is going like, not like that flow, like one sip, that's okay. Because what happens, the reason of that, because our body, the nature of the body is always hot, you know. And when we are doing posture, when we are doing yoga, that creates also the energy. And that creates the hot, more and more energetic body. And then what happens? Even you are drinking hot water. Even you are drinking hot water. Nature of the water always cool. Even you are drinking hot water. Nature of the water always cool. So what is the natural form of the water? That is cold. That is not hot. That is the cold. We make hot water through the our equipment, through the gadget. The nature. The water of the pool, always. So when our hot, the energetic body gets that cold inside, so it like disbalance our movement, disbalance our flow. Quickly, we are going to somewhere else and the turn is somewhere, like a U-turn. And sometimes, you know, the U-turn is not allowed. In road, maybe if you are going to some traffic and on the highway and there are some signal, U-turn is not allowed. That's the U-turn. Okay, now. I want to listen to your sweet voice. Ask me something. Maya, what you would be asked to something?
Actually, I don't have any questions because I'm obviously the beginner.
It means, you know, don't be take my things like that way. Don't be like what we said, angry. It means we have to ask questions always. You know, questions mean you are gaining your knowledge. Questions means not that way. You question means what we think. We think that if we are asking questions, the current person will be think that. I didn't understand something. It means you understand already. You understand. Knowledgeable person ask question always.
It was a great experience. I'm happy to be in this group and have this workshop with you.
Okay. Anything else?
I have a little question for the chin stand. Because if I met it for the chin stand, because if I manage to bring one leg up, what do I engage to manage to bring the other leg down? Because I feel like when it's stretched to the floor, the second leg, there's so much weight still going to the mat down instead of up. And I wonder if there's like something to think about and to engage to actually bring the second leg to join the other.
Okay, first thing is that for scientifically, we need four. We need elbow. Okay? Then other way, for my experience, if you believe me, first thing is that Virasana, Vajrasana, more and more to get light your leg. If your legs are heavy, it's very difficult to lift it up. If your legs, before any inversion, before any balance, you have to stay in Virasana, like a hero pose, long. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. That give you the lightness of the leg. So when we are sitting quickly in Virasana, what happens? You feel one here. We feel one here. Is it? Why we feel one here? Because the leg open. Why we feel one here? Because the heaviness of the leg, heaviness of the stimulus. So that's my own experience. When I did the palm balance, now maybe that's not up to me, but I can do every kind of palm balance. Every kind of balance, from the downward, from the crane, from the wider, from the anything, from the stem here, there. That experience only comes through that. I started Virasana longer, half an hour, 15 minutes, 10 minutes every day. Then I make light my life. So that's my own perception. And then see, other things, our inhale exhale. As I mentioned maybe yesterday also, how much our inhale exhale in each and every posture. Then your inhale exhale will be support to you. It means if you are doing like triangle pose. Suppose you are doing triangle pose. How you are in here? If you are doing Surya Namaskar, see, my inhale. Each and every posture has the inhale like that. Otherwise, what we do? We do Surya Namaskar. Even we are teaching. Me too, before I did that. I am only through the mouth, I am speaking inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. But I was not using, believe me, never that way inhale, exhale. And even the friend also, they are speaking very nice. Inhale, exhale, calm down. Inhale, leg up, exhale down. But how much time we do through our voice that inhale and exhale? So verbal way we speak, but internal way we never. You believe me? We did that. So just what you are speaking, go that way. If you are speaking inhale, so that much longer you are inhale. If you are speaking exhale, so same time your body movement also that will exhale. If you are saying inhale, so you are inhale. Exhale. So it means your exhale is going how much you are extending your body that exhale way. It means you are doing inhale. A lot of from 5 inhale exhale from here to here. This journey from here to here, I did how long? I don't know. How many inhale and exhale? That is only one, always. So that much longer. If that much longer you will use, definitely within 1 week, within 1 month, you will get that awareness of lifted your leg up. Then you find that how much lightness. One is the Virasana, thunderbolt, like bending leg. Stay there 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes every day. Lightness would become, and then same time you are breathe there. So definitely you will do. Then you will be getting that how you are lifted your body up. Like if you are doing crane pose, if I am doing supposed crane pose here, so see, I am forcing my body towards the mat because my body is going down here. If I am lifting my body up, see, so I am gaining that. How much? It means my body is not going down. My body is going to up. Even your knees, I am not saying you have to lift that much. I am saying even you are supported with your knees on your elbow, on your upper arm, but you have to gain that how you are lifted your body up. They are only support. They are not squeezing down. So that's only through the inhale exhale. That only through the lightness of the body. Okay?
Anoop,
thank you. Yes,
I also have a question to the chin stand. I feel, for me, I have to be more open in the front. Is this also a little bit of a back bend for the chin stand?
Yeah, no, from your chest and sternum region, you need to.
Pardon?
From this area.
From this area, I should? What?
Yes, it's looking there.
I do it?
For left area.
I do it now. Or what?
Okay, do that. Do
no, I don't understand.
Do the cobra pose. First, do the cobra,
cobra pose.
Do the cobra pose, then I show you. Cobra, elbow down.
Elbow down.
More down. Arm here, and just open the face. Shoulder back. Now move the head back.
Head back.
Now do the upward dog. Stretch the arm. Upward facing.
Upward, sorry. Upward facing.
Yes, it's okay. Do. Now see. Now. See, this is also the key point in extent. Okay, before you, I will reply to your question. See, this is also here. The task to open this area.
Okay, yeah.
So see the chin, how much chin is going far? Chin is going far. Chest is on the wall, but chin is going too far. Chest on the wall, but chin is going far. It means if your chin is like this, then you are. So chin, okay, now ask me. Chin is thin. Actual person now ask me actual person. You see.
What?
But you ask me again, ask me person. Same person.
I feel that I have to open the front body for this. This is correct.
Front body? Yes, front body is little bit you have to open the air. Same time you have to do this kind of exercise to open that area. And then more work on your and like a witch poster, like head stand, like palm balance, to gain that stability to lift it up your body.
Okay. Yes. Thank you. Dhanyavaad.
Okay, before that, one thing more. And actually what happens, we are human beings and everybody has something different. We are not equal. It means I am not much better in back bend, but I am better in balance. Maybe you are better in back bend, but you are not better in forward bend.
I also, okay. Yeah.
Yes.
Go.
So there are different body. If you have in your class 20 people, so they are different.
Yes.
But as a teacher, that's our duty, how to teach them, what we have to teach them. See, if you want to go in top, there are two ideas. One idea, you have to, from the top person, you have to move that person to top. That is one idea. But if that is very difficult to you, already there are 10 people from the top. So very difficult to move those 10 people from down. So that time you can do one thing very different, which is different than 10. So people come to you. So people want to watch you. Because you have something different than 10. And if you want to also equal, okay, I want to also that same top, I want to also send good number one, it's not possible. All the life, you will be give your energy set that way. But if you want to gain something, you have to do something different. So it means, if you are in some posture, anybody, if you think that you are not okay in that posture, you have to keep continuing. So you are stressor for something else. So not be push your energy unnecessary, even just some other work in our life. If something you are from the few years, you are losing your energy every day. And like triangle pose, like downward dog. We think, oh, these are simple postures, downward dog. I want to scorpion. I want to put my feet on my head. So then what to do? What is the result of that? You will gain your purpose of yoga? Maybe not. That is not the purpose of yoga, feet on the head there. There are a lot of masters in all over the world. They cannot fit on the head, but they are not. not purpose means how we are treating the people, how we are giving the people like a remove their disease, reduce their therapeutical way, their disease, their if they have some injury, if they have some weakness in their body, we are, that's the name of yoga. It's spreading our knowledge. It's not me, we are showing them our formulas and then say, okay, you have to do. That doesn't say, I cannot. No, you have to do. That's not forcing. It means from the triangle, from the downward up, from the extremity, from the samasthiti, from the tadasana, we are getting our extremity. Tadasana, only five posture is okay for one day, for one class. But in that class, five posture, what those people want to learn from you and what they learn exactly. If the somebody comes to the same class and then Sammy teaching those people, and the next day those people, oh, yesterday Sam, Sammy teach us something different in tadasana. He said, height is this way, the pelvic is this way, tailbone is this way. They will come again to Sammy class. If the Sam is also repeat shown all the ready-made sentences, what they are already using in YouTube, Google, every Wikipedia from the book, and then Sam is also being sending. So why they come? They will go definitely to the YouTube. But if the Sam is teaching them from his own knowledge, from his own experience, light on yoga, from the BK angle, not from the Anu, not from the Sammy, and not from the Mela, not from anyone. Light on yoga from the BK angle. What he gets, his knowledge is there. We can just read his knowledge, how he did. But we cannot apply his knowledge in our stuff. Because his body and he was in 2004. But we are in now 2021. Now the food is also different, energy is also different, environment is also different, people are also different. So we cannot copy those people. But we can do something good for humanity. That's our purpose. In the name of you. Here, you will be game. But if you want to copy, if you want to always, okay, how many poles, how to open my hip, you too, etc. Google, say me, how to open my hip. And Google says, there is one lady in Google, comes and says, okay, inhale, comes up, exhale, down. And after 2 months, I bring that hip opening, I think, oh, there, I did not. So, okay, sometimes okay for you to put on that, that's good. But try to understand through your arm. Because that lady's body and your body is different. So why you want to copy that lady? And how much that lady has the experience? Maybe somebody is teaching to have that lady from the front side, from the other way. And you are thinking that, oh, that lady is doing well. Maybe somebody is, she's copy to somebody else because they have the nice view, they have the nice garden, and they are teaching them. But how much is that lady has the knowledge? How you know? So that knowledge always, you have already that knowledge, but only you have to experience that knowledge. Okay, Mihala, what do you have? Something?
No questions. For me, because I have very weak up arms, this one to stay in your arms and with the chin close to the floor was quite difficult. So I assume I need to do this. I need to do more practice on this. Is that right? So I can gain more strength on my arms.
Yes, and then you need to one blanket always if you want to chin stand and one step there. If you want to chin stand, then what happens? See, even in a that which posture, like pinch bhairavasana, if you have that, it's like this thing. So that will be give you little more stability. Here, if you are here, see. Your stress on the blanket will give you little more effectiveness than there. See?
So that's the practice.
Yeah, that's the practice. With the wall, with the blanket, just the near of your chest, near of your shoulder, that will be give you little support to you.
That's the only one I didn't from today. What? That's the only one I didn't do because I felt like I'm gonna break my neck.
Which one?
This one.
Chin stand.
Throw the wall, you can do that one. This one. Throw the wall, there's
this one, I couldn't do it. The one to stay like this. And you lift your legs up on the wall.
that's enough. One, see.
This one, yes.
See, I'm here, now I'm leg, my leg is here. See, my chest is here. There is no space, my arms are free. There is nothing for my arm. Only chest here, only I'm lifting my body up. Arms is there. And you have to only chin there. See, from here, what you are doing, from here, you are opening your shoulder. You are opening your elbow. And then later you can do the chin on the floor and lift your chest. See, later on what you have to do, see here. Later on,
do you mean I need to stay on my chest? No, I need to stay on my palms. That's right, yes?
What?
I need to stay on my palms, not on my chest.
But before, without open your shoulder and chest, how can you do? That's not possible. That. First, you have to open this area. I know that you want, but first you have to open this area. Without open, how you will do it? I want to eat, I'm hungry, but I want to close my eyes and food come front of me. I don't want to go anywhere. Oh, food, come to me, I'm hungry. Oh, food, where are you? Come to me, I'm hungry. I'm joking, but see, they are connections with each other. Connections are each other. So here I know that you need this one. But feel the connection of the shoulder and then chest.
I wasn't talking about opening the chest. I said, when you come with the legs like this, and you stay, it seemed like you stay on your chest. Seemed like you didn't stay on your palms.
Yes, so what I'm saying you, because that if you open this gateway, if you do for a few days, then you will be able this area open, because now this area is not open and you want to change, so that will be hard to you. That's not okay for now.
I see.
It means that's the preparation. See, if I want to do some Paschimottanasana, see, this is the example. I'll give you an example, maybe you understand. If I want to do Paschimottanasana, so many people, what they do, like see, here. And if I am saying that back is there. And if I'm saying there are people that use the planking, in every day in my class it happens. So they don't want planking. Why? Because they want to from here. So if I'm using the blanket, then what happens? I'm increasing the height of my hip and see my hip is going tall. My hip is supported, my hip is. That I want to try to understand that. If I am using this one, so here, this is the preparation, they are connecting to each other. And then see, even if I am here, longer, so now I have to use, it means my hamstring are tight, not my back, that much is responsible. More, 80% my back hamstring is responsible. There. So now, I need to something for my leg. See, how I open my hamstring there. This way. Now I am opening and stretching. So after this, open the head to here, I am free here, and it feels like 10 minutes, 10 minutes every day. So it means my hamstring will be go there, and the next time when I am going to move, so this will be more comfortable for because I open this thing. So I mean to say you that they are connecting to each other. Like this is also connecting to that skin system. This is also connecting to skin system. See, this is still also connecting to the instrument. See how I am opening, I am making active my arm, I am opening my shoulder, my chest. So next time, when I do the instrument, it means my shoulder, my chest would be helping.
So you hold the things like this?
Yes, yes, this, like this.
And you look forward, I assume?
Yes, forward, and then chin, like chin far from the wall. So it means you are opening this area also there. When you are able to open this area, there is no chance to hurt your skin. In your case, what happens? The arms are little any questions, you can ask me later. Okay, now, anything else? It's okay now?
Yes, for me it's okay. Anyone else? Okay, thank you so much for the last 2 days.
Okay.
I talk to you later. Stay with me, Anup, and the rest we can go, okay?
Okay,
thank you so much. Thank you everyone for joining. Thank you, Jana, Jana, Mihaila, Sami, Maya. Thank you. Okay,